south of the interstate bridge here, just north of the airport. There's shuttle service that gets people.
As you can see, I'm in the middle of my flock training program to secure. As you can see, I'm in the middle of my flock training program, and it's not too late for you to start to secure adoption papers.
We'll be dying down, and tomorrow looks to be just lovely. But out here, it just makes me think, man, I'm glad that they're going to be having the permanent location upriver by something attractive. It's so ugly down here. We have clear sky.
Good evening. The National Weather Service continues a winter storm warning through tonight. Snow expected to continue through tomorrow, ending tomorrow afternoon with total accumulations of 8 to 12 inches across parts of the area. 6 to 12 best chances right across the Siouxland area and on up to the Duluth.
Our trains are running towards each other. Shotguns are pointed at my head. Tornado clouds are forming o'er the crossroads. H-bombs are falling towards my bed. But I'm still here. I'm still here, and how about that? My city may be falling, but I'm still here. The assassination squad has got their orders. Repossession man is on his way. Landlady's given me her notice. I'll get pitched out with the trash just any day. But I'm still here. I'm still here, and how about that? I may have lost my lunchbox, but I'm still here. While the moths bait my shirt, my britches, they're working on my hat, but I don't care. I haven't had a meal since the fire went out. And all you do is stand around and stare, but I'm still here. I'm still here, and how about that? I might not hear you laughing, but I'm still here.
Listening to a moving rendition of Amazing Grace, performed by the Phantom Regiment Drum and Bugle Corps. Tom Peterson was the voice of KCAU TV's Drums Across America and loved this music. As you know, we lost Tom this past week. His achievements, the love he shared, the unique way he communicated to his audience, the good he did, have forged memories we'll keep forever. On behalf of the entire KCAU family, thank you for the untold number of thoughtful acts and expressions of support you've shown us. It has meant more to us than words can ever express. Your kindness and the way Tom lived his life with such amazing grace will never be forgotten.
Tom Peterson was a Siouxlander through and through. He was mugging for the camera from the start. His parents, Lloyd and May Peterson, welcomed Tom to the Peterson family in Sioux City in 1948. He joined two sisters, Carolyn and Robbie. It was off to Bryant School, where friends say the first inkling of Tom's effervescent personality shone through. He was a Cub Scout and rolled through Old North Junior High before arriving at the Castle on the Hill, which he conquered in 1966. After a bachelor's degree from Morningside College 4 years later, the draft caught up with him and it was off to the Army. Basic training in Missouri, more training in North Carolina. He also learned to fly while he was in the Army, a pastime that included some hair-raising moments for his passengers, including this reporter. Tom was sent to Vietnam as a Stars and Stripes correspondent. His experiences there were to shape the rest of his life. He was planning a return trip to Vietnam this summer. Back from the service, Tom returned to Sioux City and rekindled his interest in radio at KMNS. He took the moniker Captain America. From there, KCAU came calling with a weather proposition. The rest, they say, is history, including these pictures of early pen flips, which evolved into his trademark pointers.
I'm your reporter, Robin Leach. Tonight, we come to you from a ship that's first class all the way from Rio to Rockefeller.
Never a shrinking violet, Tom was an annual Press Club gridiron actor. His natural charm helped him with countless school kids. He was a welcome visitor at scores of Siouxland schools, mixing weather information with humor and a message to study hard and stay in school. He gave of himself to the community theater, too. It was where his heart lay, and he immersed himself in all theater activities. Tom was an expert on Sioux City and, with his gift of gab, could talk forever. But he always had a warm spot in his heart for the muscular dystrophy telethon he hosted. His yearly devotion was just one measure of how he lived his wonderful life. Greg Lund, Major 9 News.
In Tom Peterson's world, just about anything qualified as a pointer. This is the room at his house where he stored a wide variety of items that people sent him to use on the air.
Tom had been collecting the pointers for about 15 years, and over time they began to add up. In fact, there are thousands here in his home. So last year, he decided to build a pointer room.
But the idea for using the pointers wasn't planned. It started during his first few days on the air in 1977 when he flipped a pencil in the air. Tom's sisters say the pointer concept took off from there.
The station started getting calls and they said, hey, we like your new weatherman. If he can flip a pencil, what else can he flip? And they started sending in things. Mm-hmm. And that's how all of this started.
But the pointer room isn't just limited to his weather instruments. There are also the reminders of his clever sense of humor that made him a Siouxland fixture.
There's a reef, and then in the center, he put in the center of the reef, he put a picture of Ben Franklin. So now people would come to his house, and they'd say, oh, a nice reef. And he'd say, yeah, but what is it, you know? And nobody could figure it out. So, but you need to look at it, and you need to know there's Franklin, and there's a reef. So, which comes up to Aretha Franklin, yes.
Tom's sister Robbie lives in Des Moines, Carolyn in a Minneapolis suburb. They say that memorializing Tom won't be easy, but friends and family members are trying to organize the services the way Tom would have liked it.
His services are going to be happy.
Yeah, very happy. Everything we're planning is upbeat, whether it's music or people that want to talk about him or... I mean, it's very tough to be happy now. I mean, we're not happy, but we're trying to make it happy.
Jim Sear, Major 9 News, Sioux City.